I'm Tracy Bankston with today's Record News Watch. He could have gotten up to 15 years in state prison for embezzling more than $200,000 from the Woodstock Fire Company. But Dale Hughes won't be going to state prison. Instead, the former fire company treasurer will serve just a year in Ulster County Jail. That was the sentence handed down today by County Court Judge Donald Williams. An audit had determined that Hughes made 83 checks out to cash and cashed them himself. He also admitted to pocketing $21,000 from pancake breakfasts held by the Woodstock Fire Company. Hughes has repaid most of the stolen money. The judge's sentence also reflected pleas for leniency from some fire company colleagues. He was initially charged with murder and illegal weapons possession in connection with the fatal shooting of 23-year-old Newburgh resident Justin Doctor during a gunfight outside a Newburgh bar back in October. But 21-year-old Charles Alexander will not be facing any criminal charges for his role in the incident. Today, the Orange County District Attorney's Office reported that a grand jury had returned a no bill, meaning no criminal charges will be filed against Alexander. The grand jury determined that Alexander was justified in the use of deadly force following the review of surveillance video. It showed Doctor placing a pistol to the head of Alexander's brother, Scotty. The gun jammed, and Charles Alexander was handed a gun. He then fired three shots, fatally wounding Doctor. The DA's office says the law allows a person to use deadly physical force to defend himself or a third person. It's become a familiar story, and it was playing out again, this time in the Warwick School District, where declining state financial aid is putting another area elementary school at risk. Last night in Warwick, residents and business owners showed up at a public hearing to sound off against the proposed closing of either Park Avenue Elementary School or Kings Elementary as a way to help the district close a projected $3 million budget shortfall. Superintendent Ray Bryant told community members that the loss of more than $11 million in state aid is forcing the Warwick District to look at the closing of a school, most likely Park Avenue Elementary. Fiscal problems led to the closing of the district's Pine Island Elementary back in 2011. More than 1,400 signatures have been collected on a petition in an attempt to keep Park Avenue School open. The Warwick School Board is expected to decide on a course of action during their meeting next Monday. Meantime, the loss of state education aid prompted a group of Valley Central School District residents to take a trip to Albany today. They were to meet with state legislators from the Hudson Valley region in hopes of convincing them to fight for more state financial support for their district that now faces a variety of proposed cuts, including staff and program reductions, as well as the possible closing of the district's Maybrook Elementary School. Those taking part in the grassroots lobbying effort say Albany leaders need to hear firsthand about the pain districts now face and provide relief to ease the financial crisis.
Support from the state has been diminished over several years. And this is why I want to go up there and just tell them the stresses they're putting on us, putting on the kids, where they're losing out on all their many athletic programs, clubs, field trips, things that really they really need to cultivate their education. And I just want to make sure that they realize what they're doing to us and see if they can come up with some program that'll help support the schools better than they are now.
They need to hear what the taxpayers are saying about what I don't think they have a picture of what's going on in the local markets with the residents and the taxpayers and the kids that are the ones that are going to suffer. They have to make an investment in the community and in the students in this district.
The Valley Central School Board is expected to decide on what budget cuts they will be forced to make and decide the fate of Maybrook Elementary during their meeting April 15th. Elsewhere, a traffic infraction was just the beginning of Crystal Garcia's problems. The 25-year-old Middletown woman was pulled over along Route 211 in the town of Wallkill Tuesday in her Jeep. State police say they discovered a quantity of heroin worth roughly $3,000. Garcia was sent to Orange County Jail following her arraignment on felony drug possession charges. They did it before, now they will do it again. Members of the Port Jervis Police Department will be teaming up with officers from the Eastern Pike Regional Police Department across the Delaware River in Pennsylvania. Their joint effort has been labeled the St. Patrick's Day Drive Sober or Get Pulled Over campaign. From this Friday through Monday, officers from both departments will conduct coordinated DWI and DUI enforcement efforts, including sobriety checkpoints and roving patrols. According to the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, in 2010 alone, more than 10,000 people were killed as a result of alcohol-related accidents. And she parlayed a $1,000 loan into a $5 billion real estate business. And real estate mogul Barbara Corcoran, the star of ABC TV's reality hit show Shark Tank, shared a few of her secrets of success with about 400 Hudson Valley real estate professionals during a forum Tuesday sponsored by TEG Federal Credit Union. Corcoran talked about the unconventional strategy she used to build her New York City real estate empire that she would later sell off for $66 million. Reporter James Walsh will tell us more about Corcoran's success story in an upcoming edition of the Times Herald Record. Well, don't put the winter coat away just yet. Thursday will be partly sunny but chilly here in the Catskills and Hudson Valley, with temperatures not expected to get much higher than 40 degrees. It'll be a bit better on Friday with the highs around 45 degrees under a partly sunny sky. Make Record Online your source for breaking news and begin your day with a complete look at the news and features in tomorrow's Times Herald Record. For Record News Watch, I'm Tracy Baxter.